Today I will discuss on general characteristics, canal system and spicules of phylum Porifera. Among the metazoans, sponges are regarded as most primitive, low grade and undeveloped groups of animals. Body of sponges are made of cells. No tissues or organs are found in their body. They are sedentary animals, and look like plants. They are readily separated from the protozoa by the possession of many cells and skeleton in the forms of spicules. The term Porifera has been taken from Latin word porus, P-O-R-U-S, porus, means pores, P-O-R-E-S, pores, and feri, F-E-R-R-A-E, feri, means to bear. F-E-R-R-A-E, feri, means to bear. That is, animals which bear numerous pores in their body through which water enters the body and is expelled out are known as Porifera. D. Blanvilly, in the year 1816, first placed the sponges in a separate group known as Spongiria. Later, Huxley, in the year 1875, and Solus, in the year 1884, separated sponges from metazoa and placed the sponges in a separate subdivision called Parazoa, P-A-R-A-Z-O-A. Hyman, in the year 1940, first present a scheme of classification of Porifera. Next, some general characteristics of the phylum Porifera. Most primitive, aquatic, predominantly marine, and multicellular animals. Sponges occur in shallow water and vary widely in size, up to 1 meter high, and shape, occur in shallow water. And adult sponges are sessile, that is sedentary, except the larval stages, which are free swimming. Larval stages are free swimming, but the adult sponges are sessile. Multicellular body without definite organs and systems. Body multicellular, but no organs and systems are found. Presence of ostia and osculum. This is very important feature of phylum Porifera. Presence of ostia. Small, rather minute pores all along the body known as ostia, and large pore present nearly at the top of the body known as osculum. Osculum. Small pores, ostia. Larger pore, osculum. Special flagellated cells, choanocyte, present. Choanocyte, choanocytes, choanocytes present. This cell is also known as collar cells. Collar cells. Presence of unique canal system. Unique canal system. It is not the water vascular system. Water vascular system is found in the phylum Echinodermata. It is the canal system present in phylum Porifera. Internal skeleton, either spicules or spongin fibers, or made up of both spicules and spongin fibers. Either spicules or spongin fibers, or made up of with both spicules and spongin fibers. All possesses great power of regeneration. All possesses great power of regeneration. No mouth, no nervous system, no sensory cell. Body generally flower or vase-like or tubular, with radial symmetry or without any symmetry. Symmetry may be radial or without any symmetry. Flower or vase-like or tubular. Flower vase-like or tubular. Reproduction sexual or asexual. Asexual by gametes. Gametes, G-E-M-M-U-L-E-S, gametes. Development indirect. Two types of larvae, Amphiblastula and Parenchymula, are found in their life cycle. Larvae are of two types, Amphiblastula and Parenchymula, Amphiblastula, Amphiblastula and Parenchymula, Parenchymula, Parenchymula. Next, we'll discuss about the poriferan diversity, some common sponges. First, Scypha. This is a photograph of Scypha. This large pore is known as osculum. Osculum present at the top of the cylinder. At the top of the cylinder. And the small pores are known as ostia. It is a typical representative of phylum Porifera. Earlier, it has been termed as cycon, commonly called as cycon. They are found to be attached with some substratum below 100 meter depth. They may live single or may form colonies. They look like flower vase, and at the apex there is a large opening known as osculum, plural oscula, O-S-C-U-L-A, oscula. Body is traversed by many pores through which water enters the body. These pores are known as ostia, O-S-T-I-A, ostia. The water enters through ostia and comes out through osculum. Waters enters through ostia and comes out through osculum. They are studied in all universities and colleges as a typical representative of porifera. Next, another specimen, Euplectella species. Euplectella species. They are commonly known as Venus flower basket. Venus flower basket. The body is cylindrical and curved. The anterior part looks like a sieve. Sieve. S-I-E-V-E. Sieve. And posterior part has a so-called roof. Roof. R-O-O-F. The roof is formed of spicules. They are found in deep sea near Philippines Island. Next specimen is Spongilla. Spongilla, S-P-O-N-G-I-L-L-S, Spongilla species. They are found in freshwater ponds or lakes and even in currentless streams. They grow on submerged plant or wooden log. They produce many branches of the body cell. Their body contains Chlorella. Their body contains Chlorella. As that is why the body appears green. As that is why the body appears green. So here two questions arise. Name one freshwater porifera or name one freshwater sponge. The answer is Spongilla. And name the symbiotic sponge. Symbiotic sponge, that is Spongilla, which contain Chlorella. Next specimen is Chalina. Chalina species. It is commonly known as dead man's finger. Looks like a finger. Dead man's finger. Each finger contains many osculi. The body color is nearly red or orange or yellow or mixed. They are found in the deep sea starting from Labrador to Rhode Island. Next sponge is Eusporangia. Eusporangia. They are commonly known as bath sponge. Bath sponge. They are brown in color and the body skeleton is formed of spongin fiber. Mind it, the body skeleton is formed of spongin fiber, S-P-O-N-G-I-N, spongin fiber. The body consists of many small outgrowths known as conuli, conuli. C-O-N-U-L-I. They are found in plenty in the deep sea of Australia and West Indies. Now, I discuss about the internal anatomy of sponge. This is a structure of sponge and this cavity, large cavity, is known as spongocoel. This cavity is lined with the special flagellated cell. This cell is known as choanocyte. This is a choanocyte or collar cell and this is flagellum. These are the flagellum of choanocyte. The pores or pore here is known as ostium, singular ostium, O-S-T-I-U-M. The line, the ostium is lined by porocyte cell, porocyte cell. This is amebocyte cell present in the layer, present in the body layer, amebocyte cell. This is the base. This region is known as mesohyl. Internal skeleton is made up of spicules. This is a spicule. This is a spicule. This is monaxon. This is triaxon spicule. The spicules harden or stiffens the body. This is pinacocyte cell. pinacocyte cell, last outer covering of the cell, pinacocyte, it produce pinacoderm. The layer is known as pinacoderm, and that the large cavity or the large pore at the apex or top of the animal is known as osculum. So this is osculum, this cavity is spongocoel, small pores are ostia, each pore is lined by porocyte, inner side of spongocoel is lined by guanocyte, body skeleton is made up of spicule. And this area is known as mesohyl, archaeocyte or amebocyte type of cell also present in the body layer. Next, we give special emphasis to the structure of guanocyte or collar cells. Some or all of the interior side of the body, that is the spongocoel, the main cavity, is lined with special flagellated cells, the guanocytes, which acts as a pump to bring water in and outside the body. This is a guanocyte cell, this is a collar region, so this cell is known as collar cell. Long flagellum, singular flagellum present, food particles in mucus, phagocyte of food particles, this is phagocyte of food particles, and the base is a amebocyte cell. In the base there is a amebocyte cell, amebocyte, guanocyte cell, flagellum, collar region. Now I will discuss about the canal system in porifera. The canal system in porifera ranges from simple grade to highly complex form. It consists of ostia, various channels, and osculum. Different types of canal system. It is a scheme or summary of a different types of canal system. Ascoid type, ascoid, syconoid, leuconoid, ragon, four major types: ascoid type, syconoid type, leuconoid type, and ragon type. Ascoid type, example, leucosolenia, leucosolenium. Syconoid type, grade 1 and grade 2. Grade 1, example, scypha. Grade 2, example, grandiopsis. Grandiopsis. Leuconoid type. This type is again subdivided into three other types: Eurypylus type, aphodal type, diplodal type. Eurypylus type, example, leucilla. Leucilla, aphodal type, example, geodia, geodia, diplodal type, example, oscarella, oscarella, ragon type, example, spongilla, spongilla. First, we'll discuss about the ascoid type of canal system. Ascoid type of canal system. This is simplest form of canal system found in sponges. This type represents a hollow cylinder which remains attached to the substratum by its base. The body surface is covered by a single layer of flat cells called the pinacoderm or platter skin. Pinacoderm is most popular. The hollow cavity is called the atrium or spongocoel. Is lined with a single layer of flagellated collar cells called guanoderm or collar skin. A large number of minute pores perforate the wall of the cylinder. These pores are called ostia. There is a big opening of the cylinder at the upper free end of the body called osculum. So, this is a photograph of ascoid type of canal system. This is base. This cavity is known as spongocele. This is osculum and the pores are ostia, ostium singular, spongocele lined by choanocyte cell, yellow in color. This ostia is dermal ostia. This red layer is known as pinacoderm. Between pinacoderm and the inner cavity, there is a mesenchyme. Inner layer is known as choanoderm. So, choanoderm, in between choanoderm and pinacoderm, there is a layer called mesenchyme. Water enters into the body through dermal ostia, then goes to spongocele, and then outgoing water goes through to the outside through osculum. It is the simplest type of canal system and found in radially symmetrical vase-like sponges. Very thin walled body encloses a large cavity known as spongocele. The spongocele opens outside by a narrow opening at the summit known as osculum. The spongocele is lined by colored cells or choanocytes. The dermal or outer epithelium or epidermis consist of flat cells and mesenchyme lie in between the epidermis and inner epithelium. The mesenchyme contains skeletal elements and amebocytes. The wall is pierced by microscopic apertures known as ostia or incurrent pores, which extend from the epidermis to the spongocele. Each pore is intracellular, that is, it is canal through a conical cell known as porocyte, and the water current is impelled by choanocytes. The canal through porocyte is known as prosopile. Now we study the water flow. Water flow from exterior, water goes to dermal pores, then internal ostia, spongocele, and goes exterior through osculum. So this is a simple type, ascon type. Ingression water through ostia, then to spongocele, and then go outside through osculum. The flagellated choanoderm creates an unidirectional water flow. The flagellated cell choanocyte creates an unidirectional water flow. The water flow thus created enters the ostia, passes over the choanoderm, moves towards the atrium. From atrium, water goes out of the body through the osculum. The circulatory system created here involving the choanoderm, ostia, atrium, and osculum is called as aquiferous system. So, if we summarize, the course of water current is exterior, then ostia, then spongocele, then osculum, and then exterior. This type of canal system is found in leucosolenia and in olynthus 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 species. Next, we will study about the psychonoid type of canal system. In this type, surface area has been increased and atrial volume has been decreased by forming alternating in pockets and out pockets, of body wall. The out pockets of the guanoderm are termed as guanocyte chambers or radial canals. The in pockets of the pinacoderm are incurrent canals enter into the guanocyte chamber through numerous small openings called prosopiles. This is a diagram: osculum, dermal ostia, and this is a new term, new area, prosopile, invaginated body wall, outgrowth and ingrowth of body wall, outward growth, inward growth, invaginated body wall. This is prosopile lined by guanocyte, body cavity lined by guanocyte. This is radial canal and this is apopile. It is transitional grade and is above ascoid type between the simplest and complex form. It is a transitional grade between the simplest and complex form. The psychonoid type of canal system is formed by outpushing of the ascoid wall at regular intervals into finger-like projections into which radial canals becomes restricted. The radial canals are so arranged that they leave between them tubular space known as incurrent canals. The incurrent canals open outside through dermal pores or dermal ostia, which are situated in the dermal epithelium. As radial canals are formed by pushing outside of the original spongocoel, they are lined by guanocytes and are called flagellated canals or radial canals. The interior of psychonoid sponge is a large spongocoel lined by epidermal epithelium. The flagellated chambers open into spongocoel by the pores known as internal ostia or apopiles, and its wall contain minute pores leading from the incurrent canals are known as prosopiles. The vase-like psychonoid forms contain a large spongocoel which opens outside through a single terminal called osculum. So now we study about the course of water current. First, exterior, from exterior through ostia, then radial canal, then apopile, about then oscular spongocil apopile. It is a simple type. Outside ostia, from ostia to incurrent canal to prosopile, prosopile to guanocyte chamber to atrium, atrium to osculum, and from osculum to outside. Here we found from exterior through ostia to dermal space, from dermal space to dermal pore, and then to incurrent canal, prosopile, radial canal, apopile, excurrent canal, spongocil, and then exterior through osculum. This is a cycon type with cortex or grade 2 or complex type of cyconoid canal system. Again, I repeat, from exterior, water enters through ostia to the dermal space, from dermal space to the dermal pore through incurrent canal to prosopile, then radial canal, then apopile, then excurrent canal, and to the spongocil, the large cavity, and from spongocil through osculum, water enters into the outside or exterior. Next type of canal system is leuconoid type of canal system. Before going to the leuconoid type of canal system, I will discuss about the two subdivision of the cyconoid type of canal system. First, grade 1. This type of canal system, cortex has not yet been formed. In this type of canal system, cortex has not yet been formed. Grade 1 canal system is found in Scypha, the common sponge, Scypha. In grade 2 cyconoid type, epidermis and mesenchyme together form the cortex of variable thickness. The walls of the radial canals fuse in such a fashion that incurrent canals open outside through dermal pores and take irregular course to open into radial canals. Sometimes irregular cortical space known as subdermal space are found. Grade 1 and grade 2 cyconoid canal system are found in many calcareous sponges. Grade 2 type found is Grandiopsis species. Now I discuss about the leuconoid type of canal system. The leuconoid type acquires the largest body sizes, and the canal system is a complex network of water vessel. As a result of further outfolding of the cyconoid type grade 2 and further thickening of the cortex, leuconoid canal system develops. Guanocytes of the radial canal evaginate into many small chambers, which may repeat the process. As a result, clusters of small flagellated chambers are formed. Mesenchyme fills the space surrounding the flagellated chamber. Spongocil is obliterated and irregular in form. The cortex becomes too much thick and is traversed by many incurrent and excurrent canals. These excurrent canals join to form large excurrent canals, which again join to form larger excurrent canals to open outside through osculum. Again, I repeat, the cortex becomes too much thick and is traversed by many incurrent and excurrent canals. These excurrent canals join to form large excurrent canals, which again join to form larger excurrent canals to open outside through osculum. Main dermal pores, that is ostia, lead into incurrent canals, then branch irregularly through the mesenchyme. The incurrent canal opens into flagellated chambers through prosopiles. The flagellated chamber opens into excurrent canal by apopile. Sometimes subdermal spaces develop in the mesenchyme. Now look at the diagram. This is osculum, dermal ostia, a new term, incurrent canal, prosopile, flagellated chamber, this area only flagellated, lined by choanocyte cells, excurrent canals, excurrent canal, apopile, ingression of water through dermal ostia. Again I repeat, this is dermal ostia, apopile, excurrent canal, flagellated chamber, prosopile, incurrent canal, dermal ostia, osculum and spongocil. Spongocil is reduced. Course of water current. From exterior through dermal ostia, subdermal spaces and through many incurrent canals, prosoders when present, in some species prosoders present, prosopiles, flagellated chambers, then to apopiles, then to aphoders when present, then excurrent canals, many excurrent canals, then to larger canals and through osculum outside. Ingression of water through dermal ostia, then to prosopile, then to prosopile, to the incurrent canal, to the excurrent canal, larger canals, spongocil and osculum. From outside, water enters through ostia, then incurrent canal, then prosopile, then flagellated chamber to apopile, then through excurrent canal to larger excurrent canal, and then through osculum to outside. Leukonoid canal system present three stages of evolution as uripilus type, aphodal type and diplodal type. Uripilus type, aphodal type and diplodal type. In uripilus type, prosopile opening to radial canal and radial canal opens to excurrent canal by apopile, and both are present. It is known as uripilus. Prosopile and apopile both are present, known as uripilus. In this case, water from outside enters through ostia, then to subdermal space, then to incurrent canal, prosopile, radial canal, then to apopile, and then through excurrent canal via osculum into the outside. Example, Leucilla species. Leucilla, Leucilla. Next, aphodal type. Aphodal. When a slender canal, namely aphodus, is introduced between apopile and incurrent canal, then it is known as aphodal type. Here, water from outside enters through ostia to the subdermal space and then through incurrent canal to prosopile. From prosopile, water enters to flagellated chamber, then to apopile, aphodus, excurrent canal, osculum, and then to the outside. Example, geodia. Next, diplodal type of leuconoid canal system. Like aphodous canal, a small canal is introduced in between the incurrent canal and prosopile and known as prosodas. In aphodal type, the name was aphodous. It is prosodas. In short, when both aphodous and prosodous canals are present, it is diplodal type. In this stage, water enters from outside through ostia, then to subdermal space, incurrent canal, prosodas, flagellated chamber, aphodous, excurrent canal, osculum, and then into the outside. Example, Oscarella. Next type of canal system is Ragon type, R-H-A-G-O-N. In Demospongy, by direct rearrangement of inner cell mass, a special type of canal system develops known as Ragon type. Broad base, conical structure having a single osculum at the summit. The basal wall is the hypophere, living or having no guanocyte. Spongocell is bordered by larval flagellated chamber known as spongophere, which only contain guanocytes. Cortex with mesenchyme is thick and pierced by dermal pores, which open into subdermal space, which is very large. Incurrent canals open into flagellated chamber, and these canals represent the prosodas of syconoid type. Incurrent canals may be branched. Flagellated chambers or radial canals open into excurrent canal that lead to spongocell. This is Ragon type of canal system. These are dermal pores. Excurrent water movement, this is known as spongocell. This is osculum, ciliated chambers, and this is subdermal cavity. Excurrent canal or aphodous. This is Ragon type of canal system, broad base. Incurrent canal or prosodas, excurrent canal or aphodous. Course of water current from exterior through dermal ostia or prosopiles, through flagellated chamber, apopile, spongocell, and via osculum again into the exterior. From outside through ostia to the subdermal space, into the incurrent canal, then prosopile, radial canal, apopile, excurrent canal, spongocell, osculum, and then into the outside. Now I will discuss about the four types of canal system in sponges, mainly the difference. First, again, we go into the classification or different types of canal system. I repeat, ascoid type, syconoid type, leuconoid type, and Ragon type. Syconoid type again subdivided into grade 1 and grade 2. Leuconoid type again divided into uripilous, aphodal, and diplodal type. Now we discuss about the differences between four major types of canal system. Ascoid type, wall simple. Syconoid type, wall evaginated to form radial and incurrent canals. In leuconoid type, wall is irregular. In Ragon type, wall is simple. Next, about mesentery. In ascanoid type, it is thin and completely traversed by porosites. In syconoid type, mesentery is thick but not completely traversed by porosites. In leuconoid type, it is thick and traversed by incurrent canals or subdermal spaces. In Ragon type, mesentery much thickened and traversed by incurrent canals and subdermal spaces. Next, about choanocyte. Choanocyte in ascanoid type limited in the spongocell. In case of syconoid type, it is limited in the radial canals. In leuconoid type, limited in the flagellated chambers, which open by narrow apopiles. In Ragon type, choanocytes limited in the flagellated chambers that open by wide apopiles. The point of difference relating to spongocells is, in ascanoid type, it is spacious. In syconoid type, spongocell is again spacious. Leucoloid type, usually obliterated. And in Ragon type, spongocell is again spacious. This showing various type of canal system. This diagram, ascanoid type, syconoid type, shows the invagination. Next, leuconoid type, various infoldings. And this is Ragon type. Functions of canal system: nutrition, respiration, excretion and reproduction. It helps sponges in nutrition, respiration, excretion and reproduction. The canal system performs various physiological functions. The water current brings food and oxygen, which are taken up by the choanocytes. Oxygen taken by all the cells and taken away carbon dioxide, nitrogenous waste and other waste materials of the cells to the exterior of the body. Next, I will discuss about the sponge support, that is, skeleton and spicules of sponges. The bodies of sponges are traversed by skeleton in the form of spicules or spongin fibers or both. Collagen is stiffened by adding microscopic mineral secretions or additional protein fibers, spongin fibers or both. Now, position of spicules. Here, this is the spongocell cavity, choanocyte, flagellum, water flow through this ostium lined by porocyte, the outer wall, pinacocyte, nucleus, and these are spicules, monoaxon, triaxon, I'll discuss it about later. These are spicules. These are archaeocyte cells. This layer is known as mesohyl, and the thickened layer is known as epidermis. So the skeleton is made up of spicules. These are spicules. These are different types of spicules. Development of spicules. Spicules are secreted by mesenchyme cells called scleroblast, scleroblast, from the point of development, spicules may be primary or secondary. Most of the sponges live in moving water and support their body with a well-formed skeletal structure. The skeleton is mainly mesohilar endoskeleton, but sometimes exoskeleton may develop over part or full part or full of the body. The nature of the skeleton varies with the body structure of the species and their growth forms. The mesohilar matrix is provided with calcareous or siliceous spicules or spongin or both. The spicules, though principally located in the mesohyl, but they can project outside through the surface pinacoderm. Such projecting spicules commonly guard the oscula and sometimes the ostia. Spicules. These are diagram or photograph of different spicules. Microscopic spines, crystalline in appearance. Spicules are calcareous, made up of calcium carbonate, CaCO3, or siliceous, made up of silicon dioxide, SiO2. Microscopic spines, crystalline in appearance, having an axis of organic materials surrounding which are deposited either calcium carbonate or hydrated silica. Some sponges do not possess spicules, but they secrete organic spongin. Spongin and spicules occur together in most species of sponges. The spicules can broadly be classified into two forms. The large megascleres, 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 and small microscleres, MICROSCLERES. The megascleres generally constitute the skeletal framework, and the microscleres usually support the pinacodermal lining of the canal system and may constitute the tough nature of the body wall. Spicules are secreted by mesenchyme cells called scleroblasts. From the points of development, it may be primary or secondary. Primary spicules develops from one scleroblast, and secondary spicule originates from more than one scleroblast. Calcareous monoaxon spicules develop from binucleate scleroblast. The calcium carbonate is deposited around an organic axis. As the spicule grows in length, the two nuclei draw apart until the scleroblast divides into two. One cell is known as founder and the other cell known as thickener. The spicule is laid down by the founder and calcium carbonate is deposited from the outside by the thickener. When the spicule formation is complete, the cells move away to mesoglia. So, regarding the formation of spicule, there are involvement of two cells, founder and thickener. Similarly, triaxon spicules develop from three scleroblasts, which come together in triangle, and each one is divided into two sections as founder and thickener. Each secretes a minute spicule, which join at their early stage of development to form a triaxon. Each ray then completes its development as monoaxon. In the development of tetraxon spicule, an additional ray is deposited by another scleroblast cell. In case of siliceous spicules, one spicule is secreted from one silicoblast. One spicule is secreted from one silicoblast. Spongin fiber. Spongin is a cemented substance secreted by spongioblast. Spongioblast, which glued together siliceous spicules into a skeletal fibers that may take foreign materials into their interior. Types of spicules: megasclerals, subdivisions monoaxon, triaxon, tetraxon, polyaxon and spheres. Microspheres, spires and esters. Microspheres are divided into spires and esters. These are monoaxon spicule, triaxon, triaxon spicule jointed, anchor, amphidisc, one disc, another disc, polyaxon, and this is tetraxon, 1, 2, 3, 4, tetraxon spicule. The photograph of various types of spicules. You can see triaxon spicule, large triaxon spicules, monoaxon spicule, monoaxon spicule. Spicules are of two types, megascleres and microscleres. Larger spicules that constitute the main framework of the body are known as megascleres. They are again subdivided into monoaxon, triaxon, tetraxon, polyaxon and spheres. In monoaxon, growth in one or both direction along a single axis takes place. When growth takes place in one direction, then it is known as monoactinal monoaxon or style. When growth takes place by proliferation in both directions, then it is known as diactinal monoaxon. Styles are typically round at one end, and this round end is known as strongyolote. Strongyolote. Then the other pointed end is known as oxyote. Oxyote, O-X-E-O-T-E. When knobbed at one end, it is stylostyles. Stylostyles, when curved with spine, is known as acanthostyles. Acanthostyles. Next, triaxon spicule. Spicules consist of three axes crossing at right angles, producing six rays extending at right angles from a central point. This is the characteristics of class hexactinellida. Tetraxon spicule. These spicules consist of four rays. Tetra means four, tri means three, mono means one. So tetraxon spicules consist of four rays, not in the same plane, radiating from a common point. When the arms are equal, the spicule is called calthrops. If one ray is elongated and bears a disc at both ends, it is known as amphidisc. Loss of any ray is known as triradiate, and then it is called triad, found in calcareous sponges. Polyaxons. Several equal rays radiate from a central point. Spheres. These are rounded bodies growing concentrically around a center. Next, desma. A desma is specialized type of ordinary, minute, monoaxon, triradiate or tetraxon on which layers of silica are irregularly deposited, and this structure is known as crepes. Desmas are named on the basis of the shape of the crepes. They are mono, tri or tetracepid. They are united to form a reticulate structure known as lithistid desma. Now I will discuss about microsclear spicule. They are microscopic and scattered throughout the mesenchyme. They do not form any framework of supporting skeleton. It is of two types, spires and esters. Spires. These are spirally twisted and most common forms are C-shaped, capital C-shaped, called sigmas, bow-shaped, toxas and chelas with Ricard hooks at each end. Esters, star-shaped with large center and small arms and small center with large arms. Esters may be oxyester whose ends are pointed, strongylester with rounded end, tylester with knobbed end, sturaster reduced arms, amphiester with spine at each end. Taxonomic significance of spicules in sponges. This is a very important area regarding the taxonomy of phylum Porifera. In class Calcarea, we found calcareous spicules. In class Hexactinellida, we found 6 red siliceous spicules. In class Demospongi, both siliceous spicules and spongin fibers are present. Again, I repeat, the taxonomic significance of spicules, that is the skeletal structure in sponges. In class Calcarea, we found calcareous spicules. In class Hexactinellida, we found 6 red siliceous spicules. In class Demospongi, we found both siliceous spicules and spongin fibers. After this discussion, we have to follow some textbooks as well as material from the internet source. Textbook are Brasca and Brasca, Invertebrate, 2nd edition, Pechnik, Biology of Invertebrates, 2002, Rupert, Fox and Barnes, Invertebrate Zoology, A Functional Evolutionary Approach, 2004, Meglitz, Frederick, Invertebrate Zoology, 1991, and of course you must go through the Wikipedia. I am grateful to the Wikipedia. I am also grateful to all these textbooks, to the author of all these textbooks, Brasca and Brasca, Pechnik, Rupert and Barnes, Meglis, and also to material of Wikipedia. Thank you.